What we're doing here is asking for justice for Isak Aden. And as you can see on my poster, the police are killing us and they're using their system that's in place for them to get away with our killings. All we want is justice. Please spread the news. Get us justice. As black men in this country, we deserve justice. And we're no longer going to be peaceful if we have to. Okay, if we have to. That hasn't gone that far. We want justice. Give us our justice. We want the white liberals that are in office to do what they said that they were going to do instead of being politically correct.
Was unarmed for 4 hours. It was a one-way communication where they were shouting demands at him and he couldn't. Every time he responded in their statements, they admitted they couldn't hear him. It took them 3 hours to provide him a phone from an officer that was on the scene the whole time. They could have taken the phone and given it to my brother 3 hours ago. They gave him the phone right before they murdered him. They want to tell him they tried to negotiate with him for 4 hours. My brother was unarmed, sitting on the ground the whole time. Not once was he threatening. Not once. And they want to push in the media that he had a gun, that he was in a standoff with the police for 4 hours. After hours of negotiations, shots were fired. After hours of a one-way communication, you murdered and killed him.
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
The continuation of a very revolutionary legacy of people who are who don't take oppression lightly, who don't bow, who don't bend. And Isak is one of just a long list of martyrs for our country and our people. And his was here and 60 years ago today. It's just the continuation of that legacy. So we don't bow, we don't fold. And at the end of the day, you know, we are a people who are resilient and we're going to continue to be so.
Say his name!
Isak Aden!
Say his name!
I've known him since 7th grade. I was a little fob at the time, barely spoke any English. His Somali was great, so he would try to, you know, make me feel less ostracized and speak to me in Somali, which was very, very much appreciated. And all of you know that middle school is not really the most comfortable place for a young person. I just remember him for being such an energetic, such a cheerful and bubbly person. And honestly, it's impossible to summarize a human being in just a few minutes. Honestly, it does it an injustice for his life, honestly. But he was truly a person who brought an immense amount of joy in every room that he walked in. He carried the brightest smile and the perfect joke to make someone's day everywhere he went. He was incredibly talented and was a gifted artist. And a quick story that I'd like to share about Isak was during my very short-lived soccer career, because I sucked at the time. It was after our soccer game had ended and we lost 0-10. I know, terrible. And I just remember how sad I was because the entire team was really excited about it, and he made sure to come after me and to remind me that this wasn't the end. He made sure to let me know that all that little turn that you made and that time you kicked the soccer ball was great, was perfect. So he honestly brought up my confidence back for the next game, right? And that's just a short snippet about the kind of person he was. And honestly, the police officers who murdered him have deprived the world of his light, his kindness, his art, his laughter. Sorry. He was honestly a source of joy for a lot of people. And it's a shame that we're not celebrating his graduation and we're not celebrating the rest of his accomplishments and we're here mourning his life. It truly breaks my heart. In Somali, to quote a Somali poet, it's just appropriate that today is Somali Independence Day. The words of Wersin Shire, she says, in Somali, when we see injustice, we say, which translates into, does your blood not move? So my question to those police officers and every politician that has not come up for him and his rights and every other person that has been affected by him, does your blood not move? It breaks my heart. Do you see those bullet holes? That has gone through a human being. Flesh and bones. That's not okay.